Good morning children, hope you all are doing good. So this class I am going to give TB exercise for lesson number 2, reproduction in animals. Okay, so everyone take out SEM 1 textbook page number 177. Okay, so here you can able to see the A main. So just we are going to match the following. Okay, we are going to match the columns. Here you can able to see A column and B column. A column is a question, we should match with B column. Okay, the first one we can see cockroach. So cockroach is a starting stage development of, so here you have to mention number 1, that is nymph. Okay, and second one is a yolk. Yolk, it will be present in the egg. So next to egg you have to mention number 2. And third one, it is a tadpole. The frog starting develop stage, it is called as a tadpole. So here you have to mention number 3. And next it is houtfly. The houtfly, the larva name, it is called as a maggot. So here you have to mention number 4. You should match like this, children. So next we'll move on for the next exercise. Next we are going to see second main, so that is fill in the blanks. The first question, dash is a process by which a living thing multiplies the one of its own kind. Okay, using which method, children? Reproduction or incubation? The method name, it is called as a reproduction. So you have to put a tick mark next to the reproduction. Also here you have to write reproduction. Okay. And second one, insects multiply by laying dash, eggs or nymphs? The answer is eggs. So you have to mention here eggs. And the third one, the dash of the eggs as the baby inside it, abdomen or yolk? The answer is yolk. So here also you should write yolk. Okay. And next fourth one, dash is a resting stage of butterfly. So that is a pupa. Pupa is a resting stage of butterfly. And next we'll move on for a true or false, that is C main. The first question, the whale and dolphins are mammals because they will be giving birth to young ones directly. So this statement is true. So here you have to mention T. And next one, tadpole is also known as a maggot. No, tadpole is different and maggot is different. So here the statement is false. And third one, the pupa is a resting stage of the life cycle of butterfly. That is true. Next fourth one, albumin is rich in calcium. No, albumin is rich in protein. So this statement is false. A baby cockroach is called a nymph. Okay, the baby cockroach name, it is called as a nymph. So the statement is true. Okay, so next we'll move on for a next main, that is answer the following questions, so that I'm going to give it in the classwork. Okay, so next we are going to see, that is last main, link the animal with their young ones. Okay, so here they are given the animal name, also here they have mentioned their young ones name. Okay, so what we have to do, so we have to match their animals with their young ones name. Okay, the first one, the tiger young one name, it is called as a cub. The sheep young one name, it is called as a lamb. Horse young one name, it is called as a colt. Kangaroo, the young one name, it is called as a joy. And pig, the young one name, it is called as a piglet. And deer, young one name, it is called as a fawn. So you should match like this, children. You should use pencil, how I wrote, so like that you have to write. So now we'll see for a classwork. Okay, everyone take out your classwork. We'll start writing your classwork. Before going to start a classwork, so again, so here what you have to do, you have to write the index page, leave one line and write today's date, that is 31/7/21. Okay, mention here lesson number 2, reproduction in animals. Write reproduction in animals. So this index page is very important, children, everyone has to follow. Then you can take a fresh page. See, already here we have wrote lesson number 1, right? So now we are going to start here lesson number 2. Okay, mention the date. So that is 31/7/21. Okay, so write here lesson 2 and leave one line and write the lesson name, that is reproduction in animals. Okay, first we are going to write the first main. The first main, it will be always keywords. Okay, so write here keywords and keywords, the first one, that is reproduction, right? Reproduction. And the second one, that is mammals. And the third one, it is yolk. And the fourth one is albumin. And the fifth one, it is eggshell. And the sixth one, it is incubation. Seventh one, maggot. And eighth one, it is nymph. Okay, total I have given 8 keywords. All the keywords, it is new for you children. You have to practice the spelling. Okay, so next we'll move on for a second main. So that is answer the following. Okay, so write your second main and write here answer the following. So leave one line and start first question. What is the first question? What will happen if all living things do not reproduce? So write the question here. What will happen if all living things do not reproduce? Okay, so now we are going to write answer and leave your 2 finger space distance. Then you can start your answer, that if all living things, if all living things do not reproduce, do not reproduce, put a comma, their type will die out. Okay, so this is the answer. So after that you can leave 2 lines, then you can start the second question. I'm going to repeat the first question once again. What will happen if all living things do not reproduce? Answer: if all living things do not reproduce, their type will die out. So second question, what are the ways by which animals reproduce? Answer, write the question here. What are the ways by which animals reproduce? So now we are going to write the second answer. Leave some space and write the answer. That is, animals reproduce. Animal reproduce by 2 ways. Put a comma and write here. Giving birth to, first one, that is So it's supposed to leave one line, right? So write here, giving birth to young ones. Okay, and there is a one more way. So write here second point, and you can write laying eggs. So these are the two ways. So it will be reproducing by animal. See the question I am going to read once again. What are the ways by which animal reproduce? Answer: animal reproduce by two ways. First one, giving birth to young one. Second one, laying eggs. Okay. So leave two line and write the start the third question. Why do birds sit on their eggs? So write here, why do birds sit on their eggs? So put a question mark and write your answer. That is, birds sit on their eggs to keep the eggs warm. So here you can write eggs warm. Okay, the third question, why do birds sit on their eggs? Answer, birds sit on their eggs to keep eggs warm. So this is the answer. So next we are going to see, that is fourth question. So write here, leave two line and write the fourth question. Name two animals that A1 give birth directly, B lay eggs. Okay. So write the fourth question. Name two animals that A give birth directly, and B1 lay eggs. So this is a question. We are going to write the answer now. So write your answer and mention the A1 answer, that is dog and rabbit, and B1 birds and fishes. So we have to write just two example of give birth directly animal, that is dog and rabbit, and lay eggs. Answer is birds and fishes. Okay, next last question, that is a fifth question. So write the question, with the help of a diagram, put a comma, describe the structure of an egg. Okay, so this is a question, so we can start write the answer. Write your answer. The egg has a thin shell called the eggshell. Put a full stop, then you can start with capital. The yolk is in the yolk is in the middle which is rich in vitamins, comma, minerals and fat. Okay, inside the yolk is an embryo which develops which later on develops into the baby. Okay, put a full stop. The white and jelly like structure outside the yolk is known as albumin, which protects the yolk and embryo. Put a full stop. Albumin is also rich in protein. Okay, just I'm going to read for the fourth question. So the fourth question: with the help of a diagram, describe the structure of an egg. Answer: the egg has a thin shell called the eggshell. The yolk is in the middle, which rich in vitamins, minerals and fat. Inside the yolk is an embryo, which later on develops into the baby. The white jelly-like substance outside the yolk is known as albumin, which which protects the yolk and embryo. Albumin is also rich in protein. So now what we have to do here? So here you have to take the ruled page. Okay, so here you have to take unruled page and you can start draw the diagram of egg. Okay, so in textbook you can see the page number 176. Here they have given the structure of an egg. The same diagram we are going to draw in our classwork. Okay, so if we can refer the classwork, you can draw the diagram, or else you can open the textbook. Okay, and seeing that you can draw the diagram. Now I am going to draw the structure of an egg. The egg, it will be in a oval shape. So you should draw oval shape. Okay. So the egg, it will be having a three layers, children. So one by one we are going to draw that. So this is the first layer. So on the top of that I am going to draw the second layer. Then inner layer we are going to draw now. So I'm going to draw inner layer. So inner layer. Now inner layer also I have drawn. So next we are going to draw inside the yolk. So put a circle like this. This is a yolk. Okay. So what we have to do now? So we have to color it. So albumin, it will be like a white jelly like substance. So I am giving you a blue color. The same color even you should give children. So then it will be easy to identify. So we can completely color it now using a blue color. It should not go for any other membrane. It should be present inside the inner membrane. Neatly you should color. After drawing like this, we should color for yolk also, right? So yolk you can color with orange. So here they have given us some structure like this. Even you also has to draw it in a very thick manner. So inside you can mention the lines like this. Okay, so then you can start doing the coloring of the yolk part. Okay, once if it is done, then you have to draw the embryo so that it will be in a red in color. Okay, the embryo it will be red in color. So this is a structure of an egg. So after writing, so here you have to mention heading is inside an egg. Okay, now we are going to start labeling the points. The first one, it is shell. So write here shell, shell, shell. And second one, here we can see white jelly like substance, so that name it is called as a albumin, albumen, albumin. In the below you can write egg whites. You should write in a bracket. After that, the third one, that is yellow part, it is called as a yolk, yolk, yolk. Then here red one, you have to name it as a embryo. Okay, and next one, here we are going to draw, this is inside one line is, you know, that is called as a inner membrane, right? I-N-N-E-R, inner membrane, M-E-M-B-R-A-N-E, inner membrane. So then last, here you can see outer membrane, right here, outer membrane, O-U-T-E-R, outer membrane, M-E-M-B-R-A-N-E, membrane. So again here you can able to find out air shell. So there also you should write air cell, A-I-R-C-E-L-L. So like this you should draw on a unruled page. Okay, so after done the diagram, so you should write here refer textbook for exercise. So you should write refer textbook for exercises. Okay, you should write like this, children. Total there are 5 question and answers. So everything I have completed, even also I have drawn how to draw the egg. Okay, so in the same manner you can draw it. Okay, so you have to complete. I will be checking in your interactive session. Okay, thank you children, have a nice day.